Hi everyone, I'm Giuseppe Siracusano, and in this video I'm going to present our work, re-architecting traffic analysis with neural network interface cards. This is a joint work of several institutions. Today I'm going to speak about yet another data plane of Flow, neural network or SmartLink. You may wonder why. The reason is that ML is becoming more and more relevant in networking. This is the case of online traffic analysis, which is a fundamental building block in today's network, as it enables traffic classification, security, and application-specific traffic forwarding strategies. The complexity of network traffic patterns and the use of encrypted communication are driving the widespread adoption of traffic analysis based on machine learning implemented on commodity servers. However, it is challenging to meet the throughput and latency requirement of modern network while performing ML-based traffic analysis. Current high-performance solutions use programmable links to offload parts of the flow statistic collection directly in their data plane, while still performing machine learning inference on a separate executor that can be the host CPU or a dedicated GPU. Periodically, the host system pulls the extracted feature from the NIC and performs the analysis step. This approach relieves the load on the host CPU and achieves higher throughput, but at the cost of higher processing latency. Unfortunately, moving the collected flow statistic across subsystem introduces an important bottleneck. We performed a simple experiment that shows the effect of such bottleneck. We use a smart NIC to extract flow-level feature while we execute the analysis on the CPU. The resulting figure show that as the throughput increases, the processing latency scales superlinearly. There are two reasons for this. First, to move data from the NIC to the CPU, the PCI Express bus has to be crossed, which can take up to a few microseconds. Second, and most critically, GPUs require input data batching to improve per-core processing efficiency. Batching improves data locality, avoiding stalls in the CPU pipeline, and it allows to fill the CPU's vector processing register, thereby increasing the overall throughput, but at the cost of much higher latency. This trade-off also applies to GPUs, which extensively rely on batching to achieve high throughput, and it explains why even network-attached GPUs are not well-suited for low-latency packet processing. What if we could offload ML to the NIC? Have a look at the blue line. Machine learning processing in the NIC allows maintaining low latency even at high throughput. Moreover, it will also save CPU or GPU processing time. It seems that makes sense to execute analysis directly in the data plane. Indeed, we are not the first to use this approach. There are already state-of-the-art solutions that allow executing widely used machine learning techniques such as decision trees and random forest is SmartLink or switches. However, the solutions strictly rely on match action tables that support ternary matching. The point here is that TCAM memories are not always available in a neat data plane, costly since TCAM memories is about 6 times more expensive in terms of silicon area than the SRAM, limited because only decision tree with small depth will fit in memory, with a direct impact on the inference accuracy. Our goal is to enable machine learning traffic analysis on commodity SmartLink without the use of match action table resources, and doing so while guaranteeing high throughput, low latency, and high accuracy. The intuition here is that NICs may provide a good amount of available processing resources if their architectural parallelism is leveraged. We have 3 main challenges. First, to achieve high throughput and to fully utilize all computer resources on a NIC, the application logic needs to be highly parallelizable. Second, existing programmable NICs have at most a few tens of megabytes of fast on-chip SRAM memory. Most of this memory, though, is needed to store forwarding and policy table, leaving little space available for application data. This makes it hard to implement machine learning models within the NIC, often requiring trading off model complexity for memory utilization. Finally, some machine learning models require complex arithmetic functions, such as multiplication or floating point operation, which usually are not available on programmable NICs. The key to solve these challenges is to use the right machine learning tool. Current traffic analysis rely on decision trees and random forests to classify network traffic. The problem with such approach is that ternary matching is required in order to have an efficient implementation. In fact, for exact matching-based implementation, the values of the feature selected during model training have to be enumerated as appearing in the data. Given that some of our features are flow statistics, the values they can potentially assume range from the minimum to the maximum served in the training data. Neural networks are a possible alternative. Indeed, neural network execution can be easily parallelized, but unfortunately, it cannot be performed in the data plane. In fact, the size of a neural network model depends on the total number of neurons and on the amount of memory used to represent its input and weights. Neural network uses from 8 to 32 bits to store such variables. Thus, even a small model won't fit in a few megabytes of SRAM of a SmartNIC. Moreover, neural network execution uses floating point operations such as multiplication and non-linear activation functions that are not available on a SmartNIC. Luckily, there is an alternative. Binary neural networks are an extremely quantized version of neural networks. In BNNs, input and weights are represented using a single bit. Thus, the memory footprint is drastically reduced. Rather than using multiplication, BNN's neurons perform XOR between the inputs and the weight spectrum, and use as activation function the sine function on the population count performed on the bit vector resulting from the XOR. Therefore, they can be implemented efficiently and with high performance in hardware, since XOR and POPCount operations are commonly supported by most platforms. That is, using BNNs, we could potentially solve our three main challenges. But can such simple neural network be used for traffic classification? It turned out that they can, and they are also pretty good. In this experiment, we compare accuracy and memory consumption for three different architectures for BNNs, decision trees, and random forest in a security anomaly detection use case. Note that two out of three decision trees and random forests won't fit in the TCAM. Decision trees and random forests with DEP9 achieve accuracy above 90% using 3.4 and 17 kilobytes of TCAM, while the smallest BNN achieves over 91% of accuracy using just 1.2 kilobytes of SRAM. What if we use SRAM instead of TCAM? Even the smallest model requires at least 173 kilobytes of SRAM. Okay, so BNNs can replace decision trees and random forests for traffic analysis, but how do we run them in a NIC? We then developed NTRK, Neural Network on the NIC, a system that compiles binary neural network models into implementations that can be directly integrated in the data plane of commodity SmartNICs. Users provide a labeled dataset. NTRK uses it to generate a binary neural network model, which is then compiled to a data plane program for a target NIC. NTRK provides two compiler backends targeting two different hardware platforms: system on a chip based Neutron SmartNICs and PISA based architectures. In the case of Neutron NFP, we use the Micro-C programming language and exploit thread level parallelism. Also, BNN weights are stored in the CLS SRAM memories. On the other hand, in the case of PISA based architecture, we use P4 language and rely on pipeline level parallelism. Here, BNN weights are stored in exact action units. The P4 support enables compiling to a growing set of P4 enabled NICs, including FPGA based NICs, using the P4 to NetFPGA toolchain, that is the one we used in the paper. Furthermore, we evaluate the cost of implementing BNN execution as a native hardware primitive that can be then exposed to high level programming languages, for instance, using P4 Extend. We prototype this on the NetFPGA and we show that it only needs a modest 1 to 2 percent of Xilinx Vertex-7 FPGA logic resources. Until now, we showed how a BNN model can be executed in the data plane, but this is just a building block of the final data plane program. In fact, flow-level feature extraction and importing tasks still have to be included. After the feature extraction and the machine learning program are integrated, it is then possible to load the program in the SmartNIC and process network traffic. During the online phase, the field reconstruction is executed per each packet in the flow, while the DNN inference is triggered periodically depending on the configuration. Okay, now the question is, does it work? We evaluate and trick on three different hardware targets, Metronome and FP SmartNIC, before FPGA and native FPGA. We measure traffic analysis throughput and latency while the system under test forward network traffic at 40 gigabit per second, and we compare it against a CPU DNN executor. Feature extraction is always performed in the NIC, and the execution time of the DNN on the CPU is negligible compared to the time needed to move input feature from the data plane to the CPU. The experiment we present is a stress test with traffic containing 1.8 million flows per second. This is a challenging load for a single server, being more common in a top-of-the-rack switch handling traffic for high-throughput user-facing services. If a trick can meet this performance goal, it is likely to be capable of handling a large range of ordinary use cases. And trick implementation can all achieve the offered throughput of 1.8 million flows analysis per second. Instead, even using larger batch sizes, the CPU is unable to cope with such load. The CPU can achieve a maximum throughput of 1.18 million analyzed flows per second, only when using very large batches of 10K flows. More interesting, N-Trick implementation provides also a low processing latency, 42 microseconds for N-Trick NFP, and only 2 and 0.5 microseconds for N-Trick before and N-Trick FPGA. In comparison, for the CPU executor to achieve a throughput above the 1 million flows per second, the processing latency is 1 millisecond and 8 milliseconds with batch size of 1K and 10K. We present an additional experiment using a different feature extraction strategy that performs full TCP state tracking. We use 500, 1K and 10K parallel HTTP flows to generate a total rate of 40 gigabit per second. Since TCP flows have a larger average packet size close to the maximum packet size, this corresponds to about 3.2 million packets per second offline rate. We further instrument and trick to perform inference on a flow every 10 received flow packets. This corresponds up to 320K inference per second. And trick can forward all the received packets while collecting statistics and performing ML inference. An interesting observation is that the NFP throughput does not change when adding and trick inference mode. This happens since feature extraction requires memory lookup, whereas BNN inference requires mostly processing power of the NFP executor. Thus, the two workloads can be efficiently collocated. In a nutshell, BNNs can replace decision trees at random forest for traffic analysis use cases. They can be efficiently implemented in different architectures. And trick compiles BNN models into implementations that can be directly integrated in the data plane of commodity smart nics. Adding BNN dedicated hardware in SmartNIC comes at low cost. This is an enabler for further use cases. On the other hand, I think it's necessary to point out some limitations. Only features that can be computed or extracted within the data plane can be used as input. For instance, N-Trick is not suited for models that require application-level data, such as packet payloads. SmartNIC are limited to small models. Basically, I will not suggest them to do image processing. Thank you for your attention. I'm looking forward to your follow-up questions. The code is open source on GitHub, and please check the paper for more details.